Hey guys, you're Jamie here, Snowman 86. We are back on Bally Spring. So, a couple of things have changed since we were last on. We've had to do a full reset of the system, so a couple of settings might be a little bit off, but for the most part, I'm hoping we're okay. This will be the ultimate test. So, we're here to recap on what we've done. So, we have 18, I think, bales of silage wrapped. Everything else, and we'll just sprint over here to our bale storage area. Everything else we've stuck into the shed. The reason being, we're just oh, we've ran past that. The reason being, we're just we're chewing up grass pretty quickly. So we've thrown in four loads in here of 18 bales a load. So we've a nice chunk there, 72, I think if my maths is right. We baled 90 all in, guys. So nice bit of baling there, which is pretty good for first cut. 90 bales off the bat, pretty happy with that. So it will deteriorate. It'll be just to see what we get second cut and how much that deterioration kicks in, but for the most part, guys, we are out here. So you can see the cows have already bared off pasture one, so they have enough food for today and a little bit of tomorrow, so we're not too concerned. But this is our task for the day, guys. So we are out to do a little bit of slurry spreading. Nothing too hectic. We'll jump in cab here for a little bit. And we will track away down to, this is probably going to be a bad idea, we'll track away down to the first field. And nope, not going to get out of here that easy. So we'll just, oh my god, off to a cracking start. So yeah, we'll just try our best to back out our own corners. Oh, it's going to hit stuff there. Yep, going to hit stuff there. Try again, mounting walls. Just trying to squeeze our way out from where we're loading. Not ideal, but we'll get there. Lock here and lock the other way, and I think we've got some sort of freedom there. Strange, we were normally able to get out, but not happening today. So we're just going to track over straight through here onto the first field, that we got to put a bit of slurry on. So anything we've cut now, we are going to spread slurry on. And actually, we need to bring up this. It is not set to automatic, so I think I want to be around 15. I think it's 15. We won't be long finding out when we whip in here, guys, and we start spraying. And we'll probably be throwing it on a little bit thicker than we probably should be, but I think that's okay. So if I enable my tanker. Yeah, I think we might go one more. So we're going to be throwing it out at about, we go 80, so we're going to go 20. So that's really going to ramp up our spreading of slurry, but it'll give us probably the best effect on the grass. Might show up a little bit green, a little bit orange in certain areas, but look, for the most part, I think this is the best we can do, guys. So we're going to jump external. This is the funky field, and can't say anything else about it. And it's just a hard field to call because probably shouldn't have started here. It's not the best place to start recording, but yeah, we're going to do our best just to see can we spread as much as we can. So we have our rate set. That's probably not going to change in our whole pile. I don't mind trying it out a little bit thick on the first cut because we might not need as much on the second, dousing after second cut. So we can play with those settings a little bit, but we have plenty in the store, so I don't mind using it up either, guys. It's not going to go to waste, especially on the grass, because once we cut it, it'll take a little bit, but not all of it. So that's what we're aiming for. So we have nearly completed one round, and we are already looking at empty tank nearly. So there's going to be a lot of forwards and back to the yard here on this one. But yeah, it needs to be done, guys. It needs to be done. So we had a fantastic first cut. Really can't complain at all about it. Can we get back? Ooh, overshooting. So just going to go back down this line. Yeah, we really did have a fantastic first cut. Really happy with it. I think we say 72 bales in the shed. So that is pretty impressive, and yeah, we won't throw our noses up at it. It's nothing to be snobbed at. So we'll push on, and we'll do our best to get as much of this out on the fields as we can, guys. As I say, this field probably not the best one to start with. It's just so hilly, and the camera angles, it's just, yeah, one of those ones. But yeah, this is a big one for us. Really, we need to get the nitrogen on, otherwise things don't go as well for us. And can I squeeze in this way? Am I going to regret doing this? Only one way to find out, guys. And I'm sure we were able to back in here before, but oh, clunk and everything there. I think if I play my cards right, I should be able to back in at this angle, which would give me an easier drive out angle. So I do something like, somewhere there, maybe chance that on, run back here. We are nowhere near the hose, so we get back in, go a little bit more, somewhere there maybe this time. Looks a little bit better. And we got it. So we jump in here, turn on our pump, and we get the refilling process going again, guys. So if you look at our tank, yeah, we've over 337,000 liters. So yeah, we've no issues for slurry this year, definitely, guys. And that slowly grows, the number of animals keeps going up. Are we up to 57? Now we will be selling, we'll probably drop below 50, but that will change again as we as new calves are born into the farm. So yeah, we'll just keep on top of it as best we can, guys. So just filling away nice and steadily. I think it's 10,000 liters is what we hold. So we'll get close, that number should ease up. Oh, it doesn't. I don't know what tank I had that did that, but anyway, it's not this one. So we're gonna get back to the field, guys, get back spreading. And yeah, that's probably the way we'll approach the slurry tank in future, because it's just, we do clip a shed coming in, but it's a little bit better. And to be fair, that last area there, where the workshop is kind of based and stuff, that is probably the last area on the farm that we're going to try our best to upgrade. So in terms of upgrading, that's basically not shed and build something new, a newer workshop, a newer storage area for machinery and stuff is what we'll be looking at. But yeah, that might happen this year, it might not. We'll just have to see, but what we have is what we have, and we'll just press on using it, guys. So you see the nitrogen levels, they're not quite, not really even. I like it. I think it adds definitely an element of realism. Fact that you'll be kind of in the field spreading slurry, but it doesn't all affect the field at the same kind of race or thing. It's just, you know, it just adds to it in my mind. So probably speed up here just a little bit. I do think it's a good effect when the slurry is kind of applied slightly differently on each round. It's not always going to be the same consistency and texture, so in my mind that is a good thing in the game. I do like that. Oh, very close to clipping trees. We're going to get going here again shortly, and away we go. So it'll be a fairly repetitive episode today, guys. As I say, it's just going to be a case of back to the yard, draw it out, back to the yard, draw it out. But this is really bare. I know we have a bit of subsoiling to do. I must check to see our field information up to date. There might be one or two fields that need it, and by that I mean scouted, so that we can have a fresh set of data on lime and fertilizer levels and all that good stuff. So we should run out on this pass. We'll be back, we will fill, and we will come back again, guys. So it looks like it will be a tree load, maybe three loads, three in a bit, should see this field out. And after that we will start drawing to the next furthest field, which is up behind the second cow pasture. So we'll draw to there, and then after that it's the three fields closest to the yard, guys. So as I say, one of those days, it's not a whole pile going on. Yes, we do have a bit of flat lifting to do, we do probably have a bit of soil sampling to do, probably a bit of general tidying up around the yard and stuff, but I think we're in a good place there. The fact we have bales now in our shed again is a fantastic thing. Now, I didn't use all the straw, just in case any of you are wondering where it went. Unfortunately, when I removed the twine mod, I won't say it magically got rid of my bales, but it magically got rid of my bales. So we went from having, I think, 6 straw bales to now nothing, but I'm not overly concerned. There's no one near again. Jeez, I'm bad at this. Not overly concerned about it, because we do have wheat in the ground this year, so all going well. That wheat, oh, so now we need to detach the hose, do the whole set up the hose thing. Yeah, it's the only thing I don't like. We've got to attach that hose and this hose attached there, and we're back in action. Just this tanker has the ability to store a hose, and sometimes it just catches me out. Not ideal, but what we were saying about the straw bales is, yeah, we have wheat planted. We won't have cattle in the shed until September, October, so in that regard, I don't think we need a whole pile of straw. What we have is, or what we will bale is what we need. So, and we'll probably carry that in, get a little bit of canola straw. And so I'm not too concerned about losing those. I think it was 6, maybe 5 bales is what we left. It's not the end of the world, not in my mind anyway, guys. So we are nearly there again, nearly near a tank full. See the tanker, is it sliding? No, I don't think it is. I think that was the weight of the manure or the slurry going into the tank was creating that effect. So we're going to get back out onto the field once more. We're going to keep the pile of manure, just seeing the manure spreader, it reminded me what manure we have now. We're going to keep for the arable field. A good chunk of that will be spread into there once we've the wheat off, and we'll be pushing on pretty fast then to plant canola. That will be the rotation there. And we're spreading again. Yeah, so we'll be going into canola next year, and if you pick up a second arable field, We might do beans or wheat, but it won't be exact same crop as what we've planted in our field. So there will be a little bit of rotation in that, and it'll keep it interesting as well for harvest time. We'll be harvesting in probably slight different windows. Well, wheat and canola are probably a similar harvest window, but for the main part, yeah, we'll try our best to keep them so that there's a little bit of something to do, kind of maybe late September or stuff. It'll make the four-cut of grass a little bit more interesting as well to get that wrapped up. So, yeah, all good stuff, guys. So I think the next day we'll be back, we probably will be in here flat lifting, just to give us that 10% or 5%. I think it may be 5, but or maybe 10, but definitely 5% bonus in yield. Which might be a lot, but if you're dealing with 60 or 70,000 liters, 5% of that then kind of adds up to maybe an extra bale. So definitely has a potential to increase yield, so it's something we will do. As I say, we must check our other grass fields because obviously we've had another harvest and we haven't flat lifted in quite a while, so we could have a chunk of flat lifting to do even. But yeah, we'll just have to see how it plays out. But for now, we're doing a okay job. We will not complain in the slightest. And as I say, the next field is probably the longest draw from the yard, so that'll take a little bit of time. And we had a wet old start to the morning, so happily enough, we don't seem to have any issues. Well, touch wood now as we go up to Steve's part of the hill with a half load of slurry. But we don't seem to have too many issues in terms of wheel spin and digging and ruts into the ground, anything like that. So that's pretty good. We'll take that. And that is us slurry spreaded in field 165. And we'll adjust our camera and away we go. So we're pretty happy with the level of nitrogen there now. That should carry us definitely through. Definitely will carry us through the second cut. And we'll probably have a light sprinkling after that to get us ready for third cut. So that's kind of where we want to be. So we are going to track straight to the field, and to get there, I think it's going to cause me problems. Probably will if I cut through the pasture, so we won't do it. We'll probably take the slightly longer route out the front of the yard, hang a left. Yeah, it really is a daunting long drive. Yeah, we'll see on the way back. We might chance going through the pasture, but I don't want to trample the grass there too much either, because we will be moving cattle in a day or two. So yeah, we just got to be ready for that move as well. It'll probably be actually tomorrow it will happen. Yeah, we'll just have to see how it all plays out for us. But we will cut across this field because we're not too concerned here, and we don't want to be driving across that if we slurry it. So we're just going to bait on down here and get this in. Could we get out of the gate there? Probably, but we'll chance this one down here. Butterfly mowers, guys, fantastic job. Delighted with it. Really did speed up the process of getting grass cut and getting the job done. So we couldn't be happier with that as well. Really was a sound investment. And I'm not sure if we had a huge supply of milk money there on the last turn. I don't think we did, but hopefully going forward again, now the cows are out in the pastures, that there should be a little bit left, I think, in both pastures. So as we rotate between them, they should come good now again. A little bit of standing water on the road, something I can't wait for an FS25. Rolling through that, a little bit of a, well, I won't say a splash, but a ripple and wet tires and all that good stuff. So it will be good to see. So just approaching the field, so we'll once you get it slowed down, we still have the cruise control active, which is really like a handbrake when you let up on the accelerator. And you can see the water in the field there from the rain we've had this morning. So not fantastic, but look, it is what it is, and we just live with it. As I say, it would be nice in 25 if that effect could be made, and I hope it is, maybe on a lesser scale that I've seen with the hail and the hurricanes. But if you've standing water in your field where the crop yield is reduced more so than maybe, or maybe even it completely just doesn't grow, it's just a failed crop, maybe it would be actually a good touch. I think it is probably something that could be implemented. Obviously, I don't know the finer details of map making. I've tried a couple myself, but never really got it to a stage where I was happy, or maybe didn't have the time to fully complete and put as much time at it as I probably should have. So yeah, I'm just kind of hazarding a guess there when I say that I hope it could be implemented. It looks like it might be able to. So if you'd standing water, that's an area that you could probably identify as a hail impact or something at a certain particular growing stage maybe. And yes, that would give you the effect then of a failed crop. It would be interesting. Can it be done? As I say, I'd like to think it could, but again, as I say, not too up to date on the finer details of map making stuff. Can do the terrain and things like that, but the scripting side of life is probably a little bit past me at this stage, and yeah, require a little bit of learning and reading a lot of documentation and stuff. And yeah, we'll see someday, someday. But for now, guys, we are going to be back to the farm. We'll get this filled again, get back out to the field, and we'll just keep on going. We just got to get this slurry out. So I won't bore you too much longer. I think I've probably waffled on long enough here. And as always, to everybody who's subscribed and watches the videos and likes them and stuff, much appreciated. And I do appreciate every single one of you. And anybody who's enjoying what they're seeing, me bumping into gates and ditches, be sure to give it a big old thumbs up and hit that subscribe button, guys, if you want to follow along. So until next time, I've been Snowman86, this has been Ballyspring. Yeah, and as always, guys, take care and see you all again.